We've learned a lot about our galactic neighborhood since our days of building crappy styrofoam solar system models for middle school science class. As we discover more and more about our place in space, new answers seem to only lead to new questions, many of which are perplexing even the world's best astronomers. What is the spider on Mercury? Appropriately named after the swiftest and speediest of Roman gods, Mercury races around the Sun at nearly 31 miles per second. In terms of temperature, however, Mercury goes from 0 to 100, or more accurately, minus 290 to 800 degrees Fahrenheit, real slow. So slow that one day-night cycle equals nearly 176 Earth days. And if that's not weird enough, images from the spacecraft Messenger revealed something bizarre about the mysterious planet, a 41-kilometer-wide crater with a massive array of grooved valleys radiating out from it called the Spider. The Spider lies within the 3.8 billion-year-old Tsoukalos basin, but is visually confusing. The spider's body doesn't quite match up to its legs, as the central crater is off-center in relation to the valleys extending out from it. Scientists still don't have a definitive answer explaining the creation of this unique landmark. How did Mercury itself form? We have ideas as how to most of the planets in our solar system formed, but we don't actually know how Mercury came to be. It was once believed that Mercury started out like its sisters Venus and Earth, but its close proximity to that massive fireball we call the Sun roasted away the outer layers. Another theory proposed that Mercury was heavily damaged when it smashed into a piece of another planet. Today we can pretty much scrap those ideas, as both the solar roasting and collision theories would require that Mercury be depleted of potassium, thorium, and uranium. However, Messenger found that the ratio of these elements on Mercury is actually similar to Mars, Venus, and Earth. So, basically, the answer to the question, how did Mercury form, is, who knows? If science is all about truth, who knows is as good an answer as any. Why is Miranda so ugly? No, space nerds. We're not talking about Mass Effect's raven-haired bombshell Miranda Lawson. We're talking about the Miranda that hovers around Uranus. Only 1/7 as large as our own moon, Miranda looks like she's had a pretty rough go. But scientists are unable to come to an agreement as to why this moon looks so beat up. According to NASA, some scientists speculate that Miranda's surface has been repeatedly subjected to a barrage of meteor strikes, causing slushy water to rise to the surface before refreezing. Whatever the reason, this particular Miranda certainly doesn't have it going on in the looks department. We'll therefore award Lawson the title of most attractive Miranda in our solar system. What are those spots on Uranus? We know. Just try not to laugh yourself into the stratosphere. Spots tend to pop up on Uranus at random intervals like a bad rash, always seeming to surprise scientists. In 2006, the Hubble Space Telescope was the first to officially sight a dark spot on the smooth surface of Uranus, roughly 1,900 miles in area. Then in 2011, a bright white spot surfaced, which ended up being merely a giant cloud of fart gas, aka methane. We now know these mysterious spots are most likely storms, but scientists are perplexed by the fact that these storms are still occurring. In short, these spots shouldn't be showing up, so why are they? Maybe Uranus really should see a doctor. Why does Venus glow? Earth's evil twin sure does have her secrets, one of which is the mysterious reason behind her green glow. We know why Earth glows green on occasion. Its magnetic field deflects the Sun's occasional burst of high-energy particles, causing atmospheric gases to glow in what we know as the aurora borealis. Our sister Venus, however, doesn't have a global magnetic field. Thus, by all rights, she shouldn't be glowing. As awesome as it would be to learn that there was some alien civilization beneath the gas clouds of Venus, we know that's not the case. The most plausible theory explaining our sister planet's glow is that there's a traceable amount of nitric oxide in the atmosphere, signifying chemiluminescence. This means that the Sun's ultraviolet light breaks up molecules on Venus into atoms and smaller molecules, allowing them to reconvene while giving off excess energy as light. Where did life begin?
As for the origin of life itself, the transition from inanimate molecules to what any of us would call life remains one of the great frontiers of biology.
As selfishly satisfying as it would be to learn that life evolved first and solely on our planet, we cannot claim this as a certainty. In fact, it's totally possible that life was delivered to this planet a long, long time ago.
This is called panspermia, the idea that life might somehow get kicked off on a rock and comes over to another planet so life could spread throughout the solar system.
Scientists can't definitively rule out the theory of panspermia due to the lack of any conclusive evidence for or against this theory. From the evidence we do have, scientists are pretty sure the oldest form of life on Earth is a single-celled organism called archaea, hardy little bastards able to withstand even the harshest of environments. But were they really the first? Or did some catastrophe wipe out more advanced, already evolved organisms, leaving only archaea behind? Better yet, did life even evolve first on Earth, or are we late to our own solar system's game? It may be decades, even centuries, before human civilization unlocks our solar system's greatest secrets. But one thing's for certain, the truth is most certainly out there.